way to Goodwill, on the way to Goodwill, aka a 2-block drive. Totally could have walked if I felt like it. Kind of a different environment than you normally see me. I just pulled into Goodwill because today I'm going to be doing some fall thrift store shopping. It's also Thursday, which is 50% off a certain color tag at my Goodwill. I'm excited to see what I can find. I'm not really going in with a specific plan of finding anything that I've been on the hunt for, although maybe when I see something I'll be like, oh yeah, I've been wanting that for a while. I'm feeling ready. Let's go conquer.
We touch, we break, make it seem like we feel the same. We love what we hate. We lie, but we know we can't water what doesn't grow. Give up, let it go. But we fell apart just in time. You say at least it was worth the try. At least it was worth the try. At least it was worth the try.
But they're not ankle. They're just kind of an interesting midi length, but they're just a little too snug on the toes area.
Oh, these are so cute. Just too small.
Now, I've never really heard of this brand, but they're called Regents, and then they still have the tags on them. And they're waterproof leather.
At least it was worth the try. At least it was worth the try. We keep playing games, can't go separate ways.
Okay, so it's actually a couple days later now. I ran out of time that first day. I mean, I was there for a couple hours, so I still feel like I ran out of time because I had to get to work, so I didn't get to see everything I wanted to. I have a little bit more of a vision of what I want. I would like to look for kind of like a lace, well, partially maybe like a little bit of lace, but flowy black cami, something I can wear under cardigans. Okay, let's go in and see what I find. I found this in the sleepwear section. This is almost like exactly what I'd be looking for. However, it's just a little, it's like a cropped, and I don't know if I'm really going for a crop. It also has a little bit of a thread cinch right there, unfortunately. This one is really cute knit. Again, just a little short is my problem. This has potential. I don't know why it looks so great when it's really definitely black in person. I like the flowiness, seems like a good fit. I'm not sure how I feel about the pocket though. We'll see. Okay, I'm bummed because I found the perfect top. It's flowy, it's got the scalloped neckline, black, nice material, dressy, but not overly so. But it's a medium. I tried it on, just a little bit snug.
I know you feel like you want me, and I guess in a way you do. Some space to think this through. Call me all night long. Try to give you hints in a heart to.
I do want a jean skirt, but not a short one. Okay, but isn't this actually kind of cute?
Maybe if this was a different color. I don't really, I'm not a big bright blue person.
If I'm honest, I'll just make you cry. And I don't wanna fight with you. I would rather lie to you. So you won't see, cause the pain is in my eyes. Feels like I could break at any moment and shatter your insides. If you feel my mind, call me all night long. Try to give you hints in a hard to see. Right on the
Okay, two Goodwill trips later and I am back. Probably good that I cut myself off at two because I could go another 10 times and I swear I'd find something every single time. I spent about $140-ish total, but considering all I got, I do think that's really good. There, I got some good fall essentials that I didn't even realize I was looking for until I saw them in front of me. The only thing that I didn't find that I was on the hunt for was that black cami, but I did go online after and I looked up just like a black scalloped cami and a ton of results came up, many of which were very cheap. So that will be in my wardrobe in the future, I'm sure. And then the only other thing that I tried to look for, and I've pretty much decided I'm gonna stop looking for at Goodwills or thrift stores in general that don't have changing rooms, is pants. I just can't shop for pants if I can't try them on. And even like if I wear like leggings and I try to slip it on over it, it just doesn't give an accurate fit. But everything else I found was really cool, so I'm gonna show you everything I got. There are little particles floating in the air, so if you see that, I hope it doesn't drive you as nuts as it's driving me. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's because there's a light above me and it's shining down, and or it's this candle that's burning behind me, but just to let you know, if you see little particles in the air, I have no clue what they are. Okay, so to start off with some of the fall essentials that I got that I'm kind of shocked I didn't really have in my wardrobe before. I mean, I did have this first one in my wardrobe, but not in the correct fit that I really need. And that's just a long sleeve black turtleneck. I do have a couple others, but one is way too long and flowy, and the other one is very like loose fitting, cottony. It's neither of them were the right fit, and this one is really perfect. It's thin, it's long enough, it's not too tight but not too loose. It's just a really, really good black turtleneck for me. With 2022 trends, I've noticed a lot of layering, but I've never really been good at layering things with long sleeves because it gets so bulky. This is good because of how thin it is, and I got this for $6.99. This is by Rough Hewn and it is in a size large. The next item that I got is, shocker, a white turtleneck, which I did not have in my collection at all. So this was definitely a good find for me. I really love the fit of this well. A little bit bigger, a little less form-fitting than the black turtleneck, but it's so light. I mean, a little bit see-through to the point where if you're wearing like a cheetah print bra underneath, you probably don't want to do that. Unless that's the look you're going for. This cost $8.99, which to me is a little bit pricey for a turtleneck from Goodwill. However, there's just so many good things about this. For one, I mean, the brand itself, Ann Taylor, is a good brand, or at least a more expensive brand. It's such a nice thin material, which would be great for layering. $8.99 is definitely worth the price on this one. And it's a little bit wrinkly. Sorry about that. Okay, so sticking with the whole long sleeve, sweaterish like theme that I've got going so far. I'm gonna show you these next two pieces. Now, both of these I was hesitant about at first. I had it in my maybe pile, but I ultimately decided that I would wear these. I would certainly get good use out of them, and I think that they're cute, so why not? And the first one is thinner than a traditional sweater, but I kind of like that about it because whenever fall comes around, I'm like, oh yay, it's fall. I put on like my heaviest sweater and I cook. So having some like long sleeve sweater like pieces in my wardrobe that are still breathable would be a really good thing for me. This is in a size large and it's by Time and True, which I think is just a Walmart brand. It's pretty soft and cozy. I've already worn it and I really like it. I took the tag off, but if I remember right, this was only like $3.99, so quite a steal, if I do say so myself. All right, here is the next piece. This one is ribbed and it's kind of like a plush material, so very nice and cozy. I wouldn't call it, I wouldn't call it a salmon, but I wouldn't call it a rust either. So something kind of in between that. And this is by A New Day, so Target brand, in a size large. I got this for $6.99. My next piece is, I really think this is such a cool piece. I think it's from the 90s. Please correct me if I have the era wrong, but I think it's a 90s cardigan that ties in the front that's kind of been coming back into style recently. I certainly remember at least watching my favorite show, Charmed, and seeing Phoebe wear pieces like this. And what I think is most cool about pieces like these is that you can choose how modest you want, how modestly you want to wear them. So some people I've seen like on Charmed or, you know, in real life, they'll just wear this with nothing underneath. Other people will wear a bra, some will wear a bralette, some will wear a tank top. You have a lot of options with something like this. It's really comfortable material, it's stretchy, it's got kind of these this cute hole pattern in it. Originally, it was from No Boundaries, so also a Walmart brand. This is in a size extra large, and then the price that I got it for from at Goodwill was $6.99. All right, my next sweater is this red and black checkered one. I would say it's like a 3/4 length sleeve. It's very big and blankety in the body, and it's also got a turtleneck, very high turtleneck. I really think that there's a certain elegance to this type of fit. Now, when I think when you're wearing this style, because it's so big, flowy, oversized in the bodice, you kind of want to go with a slimmer fit in the leg, maybe like a heel to elongate that leg. This is by a company called Karenhart, and it's in a small medium. I'm definitely not a small. This definitely does not seem like a small to me. Anyway, it's cute. I think it's very fall. I don't think I'd really wear this at any other time other than fall, but I think it's very cute and very fitting for the season. Oh, and then I got this for $8.99. I do have one other like long sleeve sweater, but I'm not 100% certain I'm gonna keep it. It's this, I mean, it's so cute. It's so cute. It's this cropped striped sweater. It's really cute and it's so comfortable. It's from Shein actually, and it's in size 0XL. So it's from on me, it's very flowy and comfortable. My hesitancy is whether I would wear it any place other than around the home. My issue with cropped shirts sometimes, specifically when they're big like this, is that they don't accentuate my curves and they end up making me look boxy. Here, I'll kind of give a little demonstration. My curves really start right here at my waist, and then I get much wider and fan out around my hips. So if I have something that's big and boxy up here, it just makes me look like one whole box, which is fine. I mean, not that I always need to accentuate my curves, but then I end up showing off quite a bit of belly too. I would maybe wear it with sweatpants and some white sneakers, or some jeans, like some comfy mom jeans. And it was only $5.99. So should I keep it? Should I not? Should I keep it? Should I not? Good question. Okay, and then for my last shirt find before I get into things like cardigans, jackets, and whatnot is this really cute cami. Oh, I just fell in love with this when I saw this. So much so to the point that I spent $9.99 on it, which is a lot to me for a cami from Goodwill, but I do recognize it still has the tags on it from Nordstrom Rack. It's by a brand called Socialite, and it's in an extra large. I just think it's the most darling thing. I love leopard print. I love the V-neck. I love that style of lace. You could wear this with a leather jacket over it, or if you want to be a little bit more dressed up formal, you could throw a blazer on over it. Or if you want to be a little bit more conservative or go with the layering 2022 look, you could put that same black turtleneck underneath it. So cute. And it kind of makes up for the fact that I didn't get my black cami. I got a cute leopard print cami. The first jacket I'm going to show is also kind of a maybe. I love everything about it besides one thing. So it's this black teddy coat or jacket. What I love most about it is also what I love least about it, which is that it's oversized. So what's nice about it being oversized is that I can wear anything underneath it. It can be a thick sweatshirt or a thick sweater and I don't have to worry. And I don't have many jackets or coats that I can really say that about. On the other hand though, it's a little bit too big, but it's nice that it can button in the front. I don't ever have to worry about it. I would so grab this on the go if I'm running like errands or just want like a cute black jacket that's gonna go with everything. I just know that it's not the most flattering. Does that matter? Does it kind of matter? Does it matter? This is in a size extra large, which oftentimes is what I get in jackets anyways. It's by No Boundaries. It was only $5.99. Okay, the next piece is a sleeveless cardigan. It's by Gap. It's a really nice material, as in like very sturdy, very good quality. And because it has a sort of shawl quality to the front of it, it just looks so classy again. I love, love, love that classy, elegant fashion. It's in a size medium. Yeah, I think it's cute. I think it's elegant. I like it. I like it. This next piece is something very different for me because I've never been into tweed. I've never been really into the color. I've never been into the look, the material. It's new for me, but I don't know. I kind of like it now, and I don't know if that's just because it seems a little bit trendy or if that's just because my style has grown and evolved, but I really like this blazer. I think that with a tweed skirt, which I don't have, but with a tweed skirt, it would look so stinking cute. It gives that kind of formal preppy vibe. I like it. It's by Liz Claiborne. It was only $6.99, which seems like a great price for such a sturdy blazer. The next cardigan item was this cute little vest. I've had vests like these in the past and I never gravitated toward them, but I genuinely didn't like them as much as I like this one. So I think it's time for me to get rid of the old one and replace it with this one because I would totally wear this. I think that it's just so homey. I don't know how else to explain it. Maybe it's the dark colors of it, you know, the dark blues and browns and black. Like, I just think this little thing is so darling. So darling. This is by Christopher and Banks, and it's in a size large, and this costs $6.99. My next cardigan is this long white speckled one. It has that kind of speckled eggshell pattern. It's got these cute little silver fake buttons on the side for embellishment. This is by French Laundry. Never heard of that brand. I got it. It's in a size large and I got it for $6.99. Okay, and this next cardigan is so befitting for me. I just love velvet. If I see velvet, I instantly gravitate toward it. So I saw this green velvet cardigan. It's got these nice deep hanging pockets. I love texture in outfits, and I think velvet is such a fun texture. It's by a brand called Sweet Pea, and it's in a size medium. And I got this for $6.99. And the last item in my coat, cardigan, jacket, blazer collection that I got, and my favorite one, I'm so in love with this, is this faux leather jacket. Ugh. To me, leather's always been in style. I've been buying like fake leather items for years. I just love the look. I've never not loved the look, but the fact that it's specifically in style is a huge win for me. Also, this is so soft. This is so soft to the touch. I absolutely love it. It's by a brand called Babaton, I think. And it was only $8.99. So this was something that I feel like was such a steal. However, there is one catch, and it's that it is missing a button, but that's just such an easy fix that it was so worth it for me. I will so fix this up and love it every day of my life. Something that I don't really think fits into the like clothing category, although it's still technically a top, is this shapewear that I got. It is snug as a bug. It is in a size large, and it's by the brand Kindred Braverly. I haven't really experimented much with shapewear, so I thought this was a cool find. It was only $4.99, so I decided to give it a shot. I did also get a bra, but I don't really feel like that's necessary to show on camera, you know? Okay, moving on to the next category of accessories. I'm starting off with this scarf. I have one that's similar to it, but it's very thin, which, granted, could suit certain outfits, but I'm just such a thick blanket scarf kind of girl. One side of this is very soft and plushy, and the other soft side is a little bit maybe coarser, if you will. How comfortable. These are like comfort items, you know? They give comfort to your soul. I don't know why, but I was just drawn to purses recently. I bought three. Two from Goodwill and then one from Walmart, which I'm gonna include in this video for later reasons that I'll explain. The first is this cute, again, faux leather, my love, purse. It might look brown on camera. It's really more of like a purple brown. I looked it up and this says maybe like puce. That you pronounce it. Anyway, it's in such great condition too. It opens up, it has these two little tabs on the top that open up like this. And it's by A New Day, so again, Target brand. Given that it was only $6.99, I thought it was a steal. So I got this purse. And then this next Goodwill purse is probably the most uncharacteristic thing for me ever. For starters, it's definitely not fall related. It's like summer related, maybe spring related, but I saw this and I just thought that this was such a fun purse that I had to get it. It's also not my typical style, but I really found something charming about it. Fun. It was really fun and festive. So anyway, let me show you my cute little find. Okay, come on. Thomas said it was really ugly. I disagree. I'm in a Mexican wedding in next June, and I'm one of the bridesmaids, and she told me that she's doing like really fun, bright colors. I didn't buy it for that reason. I bought it because I liked it, but I also thought, oh, cute, how cool would that be for that wedding? Tell me this is not fun. I you can't convince me, actually. This was only $4.99. How could I resist? It has pom-poms. Oh, this last purse was from Walmart. I saw it and I had to buy it, half because it was $3 and the other half because I thought it would go really well with that sleeveless cardigan I showed you guys that I got, the one that's kind of like a beige knit material. It's just this brown purse with this kind of like linen-y beige center. I thought it would go so well with that. It was on hella sale. It was originally $16.94 and I got it for $3. So, and the last kind of accessory item that I got were these Coach shoes. So I saw these and instantly I was like, no way could these be my size. And I tried them on and they were my size. And I was like, okay, how cool. They were $15, but I'm telling you, these look like they're brand new. These were in my cart and somebody passed by and she was like,
did you find those here? And I was like, yeah. And she was like, wow, what a good deal. She was like, what a good find. And I was like, yeah, it kind of is.
Okay, my last three items are home decor style of items. They're not fashion related, but, and only one of them is fall related, but I figured I would include them all since it was all part of the same, you know, shopping trip. So the fall related one was this very cute kind of leaf bowl, if you will. It's got this metallic, gold metallic handle and gold metallic trim. It was only $3.99. We've already displayed it and have put like little sparkly leaves and pumpkins inside of it. So I think I just love this. It has a very elegant, modern take on fall decor, and I just think it's super cute. The next item, not fall related, is a cake stand. I love baking. I don't do it all the time, but I do love baking. But the problem always is that I don't have any real way to hold it, display it, anything like that. One small little thing, it has a teeny chip in the side, but it's just so minute, so not noticeable that I really don't think it's a big deal. Super heavy, very cute. Good for some fall cakes or maybe some fall scones. Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself. And last but not least, the final item of this whole video is a fondue set. For only $5.99, you can have cheese fondue, dessert fondue, any fondue at home. Do I know if this has all of the materials? No, I have not opened it yet. Will I test this on camera with you? Yes, I certainly will. So it's supposed to include
stainless steel pot, an alcohol burner, six fondue forks, and includes instructions.
Oh, everything seems like it's in good condition. Oh no, you know what it's missing? Missing the fondue forks. I don't know why there's two sets of instructions.
It's supposed to come with a burner and a burner cover.
Okay, now our fondue practices definitely weren't perfect because we are still experiencing a little clumping, but that's okay. This was kind of just a trial run and we don't have our forks because they weren't provided. So we're gonna use our wooden skewers. We got some brown looking apples, some carrots, and some bread here.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, so good.
All good.
So this was like a half success. If you're getting appliances and things at Goodwill, expect things to be missing. But you know what? Sometimes you can adapt. You can make it work. This whole thing is a train wreck. I haven't even started and I'm at 6 minutes and 30 freaking seconds. All right, this is just gonna be bloopers. Keep your face out of the fire. Are you trying to burn yourself? Don't start with me, kitty cats. Okay, you cats will not be interrupting my video. I've worked too hard on this. You guys go find a different hobby. Go. Shoo, shoo, fly. Shoo, shoo. Oh, you get him, Val. You get him, girlfriend. I think it's a dual-sided. No, I'm just stupid. What is floating? There are particles floating.
I think it might be from the candle.
What? Where I'm like, what is even coming out of my mouth? Okay, I'm just gonna have to restart.